country is reacting. This is going to be a moment. Protests are erupting across the country in the halls of the Capitol today. One person who felt compelled to share her story is actress and activist Alyssa Milano. Now, she was president, last Thursday, she was present when Judge Kavanaugh and Dr. Ford were testifying. She joins us now. Thank you for doing so. I appreciate it.
Thank you for the opportunity.
All right. So how do you assess where we are in a moment right now? What is at stake? And what are the sides as you see it?
Well, I think everything's at stake right now. And I want to remind everybody that this was a candidate that was a bad choice even before the allegations came out. Kavanaugh has proven from his writings and his rulings that he was anti-women's freedom of choice, anti-immigration, anti-LGBTQ community, anti-environment. The only thing he seems to be for is the Second Amendment, and that was proven by the amount of millions of dollars the NRA put behind him. And also, I want to remind people, this is the guy that said numerous times that he does not feel that a sitting president should have to deal with the burden of being investigated.
True, but let's qualify it a little bit, because before we got to Christine Blasey Ford and Ramirez, and you could argue Swetnick, I know that she wasn't put into the mix with the FBI, but before
for sure, I think Swetnick needed to be involved
right,
in that.
Right, but she wasn't.
And I think it's
either
a shame.
Way, she wasn't.
Correct.
And Avenatti says he has a declaration from a corroborating witness. That's all going to have to wait for another day. But before we got to these allegations and his performance and behavior at the testimony,
yes,
he was doing okay, Alyssa, because largely it came down to politics. If you're from a certain political disposition, you're okay with his rulings. If you're from a different one, you don't. And that's politics. That's elections. That's consequences. So it
yes.
was really these allegations and how they were handled by him that changed the metrics. So now the question that's in the air is no longer about executive privilege or even about settled law and whatever that means to him about Roe v. Wade. It's about temperament. Are you okay with that
yes.
as a basis of analysis?
I am not okay with his temperament, and I sat in the room, so I actually could feel his rage throughout his testimony. And I felt like he was acting as though he was a political operative. He was very volatile. I've said numerous times, if a woman had acted like that during a line of questioning, she would have been considered unhinged. Mm. Also, let's talk about this op-ed for a second. If a woman had written that op-ed apologizing for their behavior and saying, I'm so sorry, I was emotional, but I was there as a mother, as a daughter. I mean, the double standard is unbelievable. We would be laughing at this woman. We would be saying she's weak or she doesn't have the character.
Yeah, look, the irony wasn't lost that Christine Ford was someone who was coming from a place of pain and was so poised. And
yes.
he was very pained when he should have been showing poise. Because if you didn't do something, your calm is often a function of your strength in the moment.
And they questioned him over and over again if he would agree to an FBI investigation, and he said no. And the other thing that I want to point out is if these women, all three of them, Julie Swetnick as well, if they were all lying, why is he not, you know, maybe threatening with a claim of defamation, which we all know is, you know, page one from the Trump rule book. Why is he not coming out and saying, you know what, I'm going to sue these people for saying this because I'm falsely being accused? There's none of that going on right now.
Fair point.
And women
of course, he may see the reward and satisfaction as getting the seat on the bench. Let me ask you a couple more things while I have you. One's about politics.
Please.
Macro, one's micro. On the micro level, you are a fan of Bill Clinton, and he is somebody who the right is pointing to now as, hey, just because they're ugly allegations doesn't mean the whole man's life should be based on it, especially when you can't prove them. Look at Bill Clinton. He was accused of a lot of ugly things. Some of it he had to admit. And yet people were fine with him and saying you have to judge him by more than him at his worst. Should Kavanaugh get the same benefit of the doubt?
No, and I don't think Bill Clinton should have gotten that benefit of the doubt in hindsight.
Really?
I think that as a nation, we were in a different time. I think that women were continually being silenced. And I think we gave him the benefit of the doubt, and we probably should have investigated the allegations against him as well. And I do believe that this is not about partisan politics to me. This is about humanity. And we have to, even though this process is so uncomfortable for everyone, we really have to look at it, look at where we want to be, who we want to be as a nation, and really examine this in a non-political way, but just in a human way. I think it's vital that we get past this and get to the result, which is something that we're all looking for, which is, you know, a just world with equality for women. And I think that every time a woman comes forward and a man can just write an op-ed, which in my view was actually an op-ed directed to Senator Flake in particular, mm-hmm. because he's the one on the fence, and a woman is not given that same opportunity, we're saying to this man, what you say and your words mean more than what this woman is saying.
I hear the concern.
And I would only...
I hear the concern.
I would only add...
Go ahead. Add your word. Please, finish your point.
I would just only add that I know that there are senators that are on the fence right now, and I totally understand it. And I think the senators that are on the fence because they do care, because they care tremendously. Mm. And my thought to them would be, you have to show us that you care about us by your vote, not just by your uncertainty.
Mm. Alyssa Milano, I want to ask you to do me a favor. I got to go right now.
Anything.
But after this happens... The idea that being heard and respected is the new empty phrase like thoughts and prayers. And someone brought that up to me today, and I'm worried about that because of all of the things we want to make sure we don't let slip away as progress with our culture. Let's see how this turns out. And then please come back on the show and let's figure out what the result means. Will you do that?
I would love to. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Alyssa Milano, thank you very much. Have a good night.
Thank you.